So a 1964 Ranchero makes its way into our shop, and it just so happens it needs a lot more work than we originally thought.
They put stuff on top of stuff on top of other stuff with Bondo in between.
We fixed a handful of things on this car, and now we get to the fun part, customizing.
Just fill it up a little better.
That is awesome.
I'm really digging how far this car has come, but we still have a long way to go.
There's a lot of different ways to paint a vehicle, and on this one, we're gonna do the three-stage paint job. A tri-stage refers to a three-stage paint job. The sealer is going to be one to two coats of white, then it's going to be three coats of layer one, and then about four to five coats, depending on how we like the pearls and the way they lay out, and then the five coats of clear.
Sometimes you'll get some sand scratches, like in these round areas, which is really difficult to get perfectly smooth. Here's a little crease in the body that if I paint over it, maybe I can polish it out, but if I do it this way, go back over and denip, I can kind of find little things like this.
We very much take a lot of pride in these paint jobs. There's a lot of effort that goes into the prep work, months and months and months. And then once we're in the paint booth, things can go south really quick.
Look at all that dust. It looks like mac and cheese dust. Now I'm hungry.
So we got to make sure that our game is on point, so the end result is perfect, just like the rest of the process.
There's a couple little spots where I know it was a little dark spot that came out of the gun. We just need to sand those down, but for right now, we're gonna turn the lights off, you get a sun gun on them, and you can find out if you have full coverage.
When we use the term full coverage, we're just making sure that the vehicle, top, bottom, sides, everywhere has full coverage of the base coat.
You got pretty dang good coverage throughout the face of the panels, dude.
I haven't seen one spot yet.
They look money. Now for the bottoms and edges. Oh, yep, yep. I see one.
You got some?
One. Tiny. Right here in the corner.
There's just this little dark spot.
When you're coming up to an edge with the paint gun, the material that's coming out, if it doesn't have anywhere to flow, on that edge especially, it'll tend to build it up. And so you're pretty much just stacking more layers of base at that point. So it'll make the edge look a lot darker than the rest of it. So we have to be really careful as we're watching this paint job to make sure that we do not get these really highlighted pearl gold edges around it.
With each layer, it's gonna add a little more sparkle and a little more depth to it. And you have to do it in the way we've done it. We picked four layers because of the way we like it look, the way it looked. So you just keep stacking pearl on top of each other and it creates this really sparkly look, basically.
All right, the blemishes are fixed. I'm feeling better, but it is definitely gonna be a long night. After five coats of clear, we are finally done with this paint job. Seeing this thing with the pearl on it and the clear coat, it is very rewarding, and it's gonna be definitely one of my favorite paint jobs that we've done.
Today, we got a special friend. Kenny Keith is coming all the way out from Maryland to check out his ride.
There's been a great deal of anticipation for me. I've been looking forward to seeing this car for a while now.
Wow. That's amazing. That is absolutely incredible.
That thing, look, I mean, the lines, and it's just sleek.
It's bad. It is bitching.
There you go.
No doubt about it.
Nice. Well, come and take a look at what we've done inside this thing.
That car is amazing. I want to own that car.
What do you think of that color?
It pops. I mean, it just jumps out at you. It's amazing. Yeah.
So this color right here is one of the ones that we've developed, and we developed it especially for this car.
That color just screamed. That color had motion to it. It had depth to it. For me, when I looked at it, it was like it was fluid. I didn't see that coming at all.
Yeah,
that's an incredible asset. Yep.
It just really looks cool. To see it on an entire vehicle with all of the body shapes, the chrome around it, the contrast of the interior, it's over the top cool.
And I got to be honest with you, the wheels, much better choice than mine. They look really good.
I'm glad you're happy with them.
I'm very happy with them.
You see, we brought the exhaust out through, skinny up the bumpers, but still leave some chrome in it. And then be able to, encase it basically all the way around with the paint. And it really just ties it in.
I had expectations. It is badass. It is awesome. Once Dave got a hold of it, and he told me he was going back to the original light cans in the back and try to make it more original, I was very hesitant about it. I can't even begin to tell you how pleased I am.
Let me show you what we did inside of here.
Great, yep.
So the door panel design changed quite a bit. We just boarded it and started shaping it out, and both Jess and I at the same time were like, yeah, that's the ticket.
Yep, no, it is. Yeah. When you stand outside of the car and you look in, the interior stands out. I wouldn't do it any differently. I love the color.
So Justin did a one-piece leather headliner in there, which was kind of a challenge for him because that roll cage is pushed up so high into those corners that it made it a little difficult for him.
Yeah, everything's tucked in really nice. I love the seats. They're extremely comfortable. They fit my back nicely.
Good.
Seats were very comfortable for me. I kind of need a bigger seat.
So the original dash when the car came in here was not the original dash. We actually cut that section out and put in an original dash, bringing it back just a little bit. I actually went back with a stock gauge cluster. Basically, it'll tell you everything that's going on. It lights up in red, which is super nice contrast with the rest of the car.
Yeah, this is incredible.
I love the fact that we was able to come up with just a very simple design that made everybody happy, including Kenny.
Simplicity is the direction today. I think I originally thought that I wanted it to be more like a cockpit, but now that I would look at it, it's classic clean.
So do you want to hear it?
Yeah, absolutely. I'd love to hear it.
Give it a rip.
That's incredible.
This is like Rumble in the Cheese House.
Yeah, that's incredible. There's nothing like having beauty with the beast. That's American muscle.